This conference will now be recorded.
Are you able to see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. So guys, this is my Docker host. Maybe it can be EC2 or Azure VM or your on-premises. Okay. Here, on top of it, what we are doing? We're installing containers, right? So this is one container. And this is one more container, and this is one more container. So again, in containers, we do have two types of containers. One is with base OS, one is without base OS. Okay, so what will happen means, so let's assume that this total, all these containers will be inside a Docker engine. Okay, this is your Docker engine, Docker application. So inside that you are building your containers. So this is invisible one actually, this Docker engine. So when you install a Docker this application, this Docker engine will be installed on top of your EC2 or information. So in that you are building your containers, right? Here in images, we do have two types of images. One is with base OS, one is without base OS. Okay, something like maybe let's go with this one. Docker Hub. Okay, so here see guys, this is the base OS, CentOS. Again, this also has a CentOS on top of it, MariaDB installed. Means you have base OS for these images. Again, here also CentOS, you have MySQL. It doesn't matter what is the base, I mean this Docker host OS. So every container, every image has its own base OS. So maybe let me do one thing. It has the kernel. So base OS means it has its own kernel. Okay, again here also. So if base OS means it has its own kernel. But for some images,
OS
we don't have
base both are same. You
I'm
mean
sorry?
OS and kernel both are same?
Yes, obviously OS is nothing but kernel. The operating system is nothing but kernel, bootable file. With the help of bootable file only, you are able to build your OS, you are able to run it. Both are same. Okay. So here, if you have base OS, that means that image has its own kernel. You can install any new things. Okay, you can do your stuff and all, like a general OS. But again, some images are without base OS also. Something like this, httpd. Okay, so see here, it doesn't have any OS. Basically, I forgot to tell this. Even like in previous classes also. So this is without OS. Now how it will work without OS means here. So let's assume that this container is built from my httpd image. So that doesn't have any base OS for this image. So in that case, how it will work means it will read the basic binaries from a Docker host kernel. Again, Docker host has its own kernel, right? So this container will get the binaries from this kernel, this Docker host kernel. This should be again related to this. So you cannot build a Windows container, maybe Windows the container which needs GUI related stuff and all, because this Docker host is Linux box. So did you get my point? Here, what will happen? The OS, the container which doesn't have any base OS, should read a binaries, should take the binaries from this main Docker host kernel only. So it should be related to that container. Maybe let's assume that this is related to this image, the container which developed on maybe Linux based application. Then definitely this Docker host also should be a Linux based operating system. It should not be Windows based application, because this container doesn't have any base OS, which needs a base OS kernel, sorry, which needs a Docker host kernel binaries. Okay, so did you get my point, guys?
Yes, so basically, let's say if the container has no OS, so it will take the default OS from the Docker host, right?
Exactly, you're right.
Okay.
Okay, so we have two types again. So that's what. So one is with base OS, one is without base OS. So which, like, whatever the container which doesn't have the base OS, it will read the binaries from this Docker main Docker host. So the by all the binaries. Okay, that's where in yesterday's class we did not, like, we were not able to install that packages and all, because it doesn't have any OS. So that's the reason. Okay, so that's what I would like to tell. So I'm done now. Please share your screen.
So how can
we? One question.
Yes, Suma, tell me.
So you said, like, all we cannot install the packages in that, but the VA editor is already installed in the host, I mean Docker host, so it should work, right?
No, binaries means not all the commands, only the related libraries I'm talking about, not the commands. That's what, everything, whatever you want to do in container, you have to map it from your again the Docker host. If you want to work with those commands, you have to map those commands from again from Docker host to Docker container, then only those commands will work. You have to again map the directory where you have the VA commands and all. Okay, so even the container doesn't have any OS. So that's the reason I was unable to open that VA command, maybe yum command and all. So I should map my Docker host, only the libraries it will take by default, not the commands. Okay, I mean, you have to map them.
Okay,
can you show one of the example? How to,
yes,
map?
So here that, so what exactly we will do means, whenever the Docker host, maybe the Docker container needs some configuration, we don't go to container and do it. So from Docker host itself we can do. So yesterday we seen, right, we mapped one directory from Docker host to Docker container.
Container, yes.
So in that case, I no need to go to container. Simply from Docker host itself I can do it.
Got
right
it.
So why should I go to container again? Mm-hmm. Simply container is to read this information, that's it.
Okay,
everything you will do it from here itself, from outside. But if some reason, just assume that I would like to have my own my commands, I should log into my container and all. So in that case, do one thing, so take a base OS, on top of it install your application and follow your instruction, whatever you need. In that way I can proceed. That is one more way. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So now jump onto your screen. Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah.
I made you as a presenter. Are you able to see?
No, I don't see that option too.
Okay. Yeah, please go ahead. Yeah,
got it.
I made you as a presenter now.
Yeah.
So where are we? So what are the things we completed? So we completed storage part, right?
Yes.
In yesterday's class, how to add a storage and all. Okay. Now today's class we'll discuss about network. How network works here. So can you change the font?
Yeah, right I click. Already changed it. I just changed it to 14. So you want me to do it 12?
Make it 18.
18, okay.
Yes. Click on appearance, click on change. Yeah. Okay. Apply. Okay, good. Now let's discuss about the network. How your network is working in your container. So maybe again, let me share my screen. So it's better to share my screen and explain via Paint. That's a better.
Yeah.
Okay. So let me share my again. So let's assume that this is my EC2 instance, my Docker host. Okay. Again, here this is my Docker container. So basically, it doesn't matter whether you have container or not, my Docker host, my EC2 instance should have one interface, network interface card. So this is called as ETS0. So do you know, guys, what is interface card? Network interface card?
NIC card.
Yes, NIC network interface card means NIC. So basically every laptop, if you see in your laptop, there is a port to connect your that network card, network wire. So nowadays nobody is doing that, nobody is connecting directly at the wired connection, but we do have that port, right, to connect your network wire. So that is called as NIC card, network interface card. So every laptop, every operating system should have that interface card. So in Linux, that interface card is called as ETS0. You can see that by using ifconfig command. If you do ifconfig command in your laptop, okay, in your Linux box, you can see this network details. It will show what is your network card name, and what is the MAC address, what is the IP address assigned to this and all. So by default for Linux box, you can see this ETS0, that is the device name, the logical name for your device. Okay. So and this each device has one MAC, one unique ID, that is called as MAC ID. In the same way, my Docker container also will have one Ethernet card, one interface, logically. Okay, so logically it has a Ethernet card, but how it will get the IP assigned, how again it also has one Ethernet card logically. Okay, but how network will happen? So actually nobody can access this container from outside. So what is happening means, in a Docker container, sorry, in Docker host, there will be one more Ethernet card will be created. Whenever the Docker is installed on top of this Docker host, a Ethernet card called Docker zero, the logically this device will be created, the Ethernet card will be created, okay, on top of this Docker host. So what will happen means, customer will, the connection will be come here from to the main device, and from here the connection will go to this Docker container. Sorry, again, from here the communication will come here, from here the communication will go to this container. This is how it works. So what is Docker zero means? So Docker zero is the interface, maybe the Ethernet card which is responsible to provide network to your Docker container, which is responsible to assign the IP address to your containers, and the communication also will be happening through this one only. So the communication is not directly from here to here. So it will, first it will go come to Ethernet. We are connecting to our containers, maybe our the applications, by using this Ethernet, sorry, by using this EC2 instance IP address only. Did you remember? I showed how to connect to your application. how we are connecting? We are using this IP only, right?
Using port, I use.
Yes, this IP address colon the port number.
Port number.
Right, so the communication will come here first, ETA 0, then from here to here, then from here to here. So this Docker 0 is responsible to provide the network to your Docker container. So if you see non-Docker host, without Docker, if you open EC2 instance and if you see if config output, you don't see this this Docker 0 Ethernet. You can see this Docker 0 Ethernet only where the Docker is installed. In Docker host only you can see this. Okay, so very important guys that you can see that. Now can you share your screen?
Yeah,
so let me provide you the presenter role again. Yeah, please go ahead. Now can you see if config in Docker host? See the Docker 0 Ethernet. So what is the range it has? Inet, the second line. See, so your all Docker containers will get the IP address in this range only, always. How can I check my Docker container IP address? There are two ways. Log into my Docker container, there I can run ifconfig command. That is the first option. Second option, without log into my container, from here also I can check it. Simple. First of all, can you do this command? Docker network ls. Docker space network space ls. So the first one, can you highlight the first one? Yeah, so this is your network type. The complete, highlight the first one. Yeah, so that is the default network. So there are network protocols, some bridge network, host protocol, host network. So bridge network is nothing but, so just a minute, let me recall. So I'm a little bit confused about bridge and network. Just a minute, let me recall that. Okay, so got it. So guys, so the bridge network is nothing but again, let's assume that I have one laptop. Okay, so inside my laptop I have Windows operating system in my laptop, and inside my laptop I have one container. Okay, so here bridge is nothing but so how you are getting internet to your laptop? Anybody? How you are getting internet? So through Wi-Fi, right? So Wi-Fi is assigning an IP address to your laptop, right? So that again, inside my laptop I do have one more container. Maybe one more VM. Okay, the main IP address is only for your main laptop, main OS, right? The guest OS, the main Docker host. Then what about the container? Container is inside my Docker host, and that is one more OS. So here the bridge network is nothing but your main Docker host is assigning IP address to your container, not Wi-Fi. Okay, so that is nothing but bridge. Okay, let me share my screen again. I'll explain clearly. I think that is the better option instead of telling. So guys, sorry for the screens maybe changing this many times. Just I want to make sure that to understand this concept very well. That's the reason I'm keep on changing the screen. I'll explain this. So just assume that this is my Docker host again. Okay, so maybe EC2, maybe your laptop, it's completely your wish. In your laptop also, you can have your Docker application. This is my container. Actually, this is my router. Okay, so what happening? Maybe my AWS network. So here, my AWS network directly assigning IP to this ETS0 device. Okay, but how I'm getting network to this container is directly my router identifying this container? No, right? My router cannot see this container to assign it. So my router cannot understand this is my new operating system. There is one more operating system, so it cannot recognize this. So what will happen here? My operating system logically assigning the IP address to this container. So there is no direct communication. So my router is not recognizing this OS as a OS, maybe the special device. So how the communication is happening from here to here, here to Docker container, the Docker device, from here to here. So this is called as bridge network. Again, host network is nothing but, there is one more type of network. Host network is nothing but directly your network will identify this as a host, maybe the special OS. So directly this will assign a IP address to this. That is nothing but host. But here, so we are using a bridge network only. So bridge network means direct, so from here to here, here to here, here to here. That is nothing but bridge. Okay, so this is what network. Now let's see. So did you understand, guys, what I am saying? What is bridge network? So my router, maybe my AWS network, cannot understand that there is one more OS inside my Docker host. So it cannot treat it won't treat this OS as a new device, and it won't assign the IP address to here directly. My OS is assigning an IP address to this. My communication is also happening through this OS only, the network. I'm getting from here only, not from here directly to this. That is nothing but bridge. Okay, so now go back to your screen. That is what I would like to say. Now,
Amar, when we will go with the host network? You said
again,
some...
if you want, yeah. So most probably we won't go with the host network. So because like in VMware it works, but in Docker nowhere we don't go with a host network. Okay, but for VMs you can go with the host also, but sometime again it's a VMware related stuff and all. So we don't dig into that network part and all. Okay, it's not, most probably we'll go with the bridge network only.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. So default network also bridge network only. So now my question is, can you do, just clear the screen first. So can you do if config? So what is the range of Docker 0? 172.17.0.1, right? So all your containers also will get the range of this IP address only, like 02, 03, 04, 05, something like that. Okay, so how can I check that? Simple. Docker space, network space ls first. Yeah, here what is your network name? Bridge. Bridge is your network name. Okay, now Docker space, network space, no ps, Docker space, network space, inspect space, bridge network. I'm inspecting how many containers I do have. I can see that now. So come slowly, slowly. So it seems right away no container is running.
Yeah.
Do you have Docker PS command?
Yeah.
See, right away no containers. Can you start one thing?
Okay.
Maybe Docker start on container. Okay. Now clear the screen.
Let me do one as well. Another.
Okay, your wish. Yeah, see, now you can see the container IP address. You have two containers inside the container block. That is the first container, and the second container is this IP address. See, how many? So each container will get the same IP address range of the Docker 0 only. Because Docker 0 itself assigning the IP address to my container, not my AWS network.
Okay.
Right? So that is what bridge network. Here, one more thing. So I want to give one task here. So can you open a notepad? So guys, everybody, this is a general task, but very easy also. So very easily you can get the answer, but let's see how many can do this. I want to change the default network range. I want to get it in 10 series instead of 172 series. Okay, I want to get my Docker containers in 10 series. So how can I do that? How can I change my default network range? Okay, so this is what I need. How many can do that? So guys, if you can complete the tasks only, if you can respond only, I'll give the new task. It's completely your responsibility to complete the task. I do have lots of tasks. I need some response from you. You should complete them. Then only I'll give the new task. Okay? Yeah. So you guys have to find out how to change the default network. And why should I change it? One more question. First of all, leave it. I given the task, but why should I change it? Why should I change it, change my container address, IP address and all?
For security.
To make it private.
172 is also private only.
For security, because bridge network always starts with 172, so we can just change it to 10 or something so that it's secure.
Yes, maybe that can be one reason. But one more reason is, let's assume that already I do have my own infrastructure. Maybe it's there in AWS or it's there in Azure. Maybe it's there in on-premises. Okay, I do have my own setup, my application database. Everything is there. Okay, so maybe now I would like to go with Docker now. The same application, the same setup. I would like to go with Docker to reduce my cost. Okay, now when I build my container for those application and databases, so what will happen? My container will get 172 series. But just assume that in previous setup, I do have my 10 series. My application and database servers are with 10 series. Again, those are also private only. 172 is also private only. Okay, now, again, in my application configuration, in my database configuration, in lots of places, I hard coded my IP address already in 10 series. Again, to call database, I should get that endpoint of that database and place it in my application configuration, right? Again, to call my, to read application configuration, I should have that application IP address and paste it into database configuration, right? Already I did that in my previous setup. Now I don't want to change that setup. I got the same configuration now. I don't want to change that configuration. I want to use as it is because I made it the changes in many places. I already used the 10 series IP address in most of my application configuration files already. Now, if the IP address of my containers changed, I should change all those configuration, the IP addresses, wherever I made the change, those IP entries. Yes or no? For that purpose, that would be one reason. Again, maybe you can say, I don't want to go with the default one, because every container will get the default IPs only, 172. So I don't want to use that 172. So in that way, case, that is the first reason. The second reason is this, like if you have already like on-premises setup, already a pre-setup, and you want to go with Docker, and you want to get the same IP address where the previous setup has, so those IP address you can maintain here. But how to do that? First of all, like how to change the default network, that is your question. Simply I'm giving one hint also. Okay, so there is a file called, open your notepad, I'm giving the hint also to you guys, /etc/docker/daemon.json, daemon dot json. This is the file name. Here maybe it may have, you may have this file or you may not have. If the file exists, that well and good. If the file doesn't exist also, you can create this file, and you have to do the modifications here and restart your Docker. That is what you, so the hint for you. So direct answer only I given already, but let's see how many of you can complete this. It's very easy. So once you change the default network, your containers will also get those 10 series only, the IP addresses. Yes, someone is saying something.
We'll have to, anybody, change this in Docker host or container?
Yes, obviously in Docker host only.
Okay, got it.
Because the container, the network details you cannot manage from container, right? Mm-hmm. So in Docker host only you have to just, can you open that file? I don't know whether you have it or not. Even if you don't have it also, you can create it.
Okay, etc docker daemon.
Okay. Yes, copy that file. Okay. cat and that file name, /etc/docker/daemon.json.
No,
you don't have, you can create it. Okay, later point of time you do.
Okay.
I can do it in multiple ways, even in command line also, like without changing default. Maybe let's assume that I want to have 10 series and 172 series both. I can create one more network also. Okay, so I can create one more network with 10 series also.
Mm-hmm.
Simple, Docker space, network space. So just a minute, I'll show you. Let me get the syntax. Okay, I'm pinging in WhatsApp group.
Okay.
Open this command, run this command. So without changing default network, I can add one more network also. Maybe, so while creating the network, while creating the container, you can provide from which network. If you don't provide any network detail, it will take default network, 172 series. Yeah, so here I'm giving 192 series, enter. Do Docker network ls, you can see the both the networks now. See, both are bridge networks only. BR0, the device name is the network name is BR0. Now you can create your containers even in 192 series also. You have multiple options. So So first thing is you can change a complete default network instead of having multiple networks. So maybe by default network is 172 series. I can change it to 192 or 10 series. Only three series, guys. 192, 172, 10 series. Always these only the private ranges. You should not use any other stuff for sure. Always in real time, the private IP address should be only in these three ranges. Okay. Now I can create my containers. And so if you don't give any option, it will take default network. But while creating the container, I can use this network only. So that you will get 192 series for your network, for your container. So one more thing also I can do it. So here, just a minute. So simple, how to create a container in a particular network. Just a minute. Go back to Google. So there would be an option for that. Just search it. How to create a container in a different network.
Amar, using multiple networks will have any advantages, like,
traffic? No, it's not like that. Maybe let's assume that I do have different applications. Okay, maybe some applications would like to have 192 series. Maybe some application, just I want to logically differentiate the application. So one network applications cannot communicate with one more network application. So logically differentiate the services or applications, I can use different networks. That's it. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes, this is the command. Above, already you've seen that. Yes. Copy that. Here, simply change your network name.
Yes.
Instead of mynet, use BR0. So your busy box or whatever the container you are building, maybe CentOS, give CentOS instead of busy box. So that container will get network from this range now, 192 series. That's fine, no issues.
Okay, that's fine.
There is no order for that.
Okay.
Now can you do Docker inspect? Sorry, Docker network inspect BR0. The network name is BR0 now. That's your wish. Network name you can give anywhere while creating.
Okay.
So see here, your container got 192 series.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Even one more task I want to give. So the same command only, but in 192 series, I want to get a particular IP 0.5 to my container. How can I do that? How can I get a specific IP address? How can I assign a specific IP address to my container? Every time my container should get the same IP address. Again, very easy, guys. The same command, Docker run command only, but you have to give a particular IP. What is the option? That is what I need. How to do it? Okay. So here, are you giving any particular IP address to your container? No. Till now, we haven't given. But my question is, how to assign a particular IP address? Again, that is also scenario will be there. Maybe your application team, particularly, they will ask you. For my container, I should get this IP address only. That time, how can I do it? Again, the option you have to find it out. So very easy. That is also only searching. You should know how to search it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So again, guys, everybody, please try. Can you post these things in a WhatsApp group? And also, so guys, even if I post it also, I don't post it also, you can get these things from the video itself, right? So I'm uploading every day into YouTube, as well as I'm providing the links also. Okay, it's up to you now. Okay, so this is about network.
Amar, I have a question.
Yes.
So for example, you, I mean, you showed me one picture, right? Like from AWS, you are connecting to ETHO0, and then from there you will connect to Docker0, and then from there you will connect to container, right? I mean, that is called, you said, bridge. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so you showed me one picture saying that from AWS, or I mean some EC2 server, you are connected to the Docker host through ETHO0, from there Docker0, and from Docker0 you are connecting to container.
Yes.
So what do you, I mean, if there are multiple containers are there, how it will differentiate, like just with the Docker0, I mean, what is that connection? I'm confused, like how AWS will connect to the container.
No, here I'm talking about the communication. So basically, why you are using containers? We are using containers to host the applications, right?
Yes.
So how you are hosting your application, how you are connecting to applications? By using port numbers, right? So let's assume that, okay, let me share my screen. So I'll clearly explain one more time. Okay, let me share my screen. So here,
maybe I'm confused about network and port. So can you explain
okay,
me?
That's is it... fine. Definitely. Okay. So this is your container. This is your ETS0. Okay. And this is one more. Maybe this is Docker0. Docker0, and just assume that here also I do have my ETS0. Okay, that is the network card again, and here I do have my HTTPD application, right? I do have my application running here. How I will connect to my application? I'll first of all, I'll get the IP address of this host, right? So the IP address is, so let's assume that something 55.165, just randomly I'm giving 33.24, okay, colon. So basically while creating the container, what will give? We'll map one port number, right? Maybe this is Docker host port. This is a Docker container port. So obviously this port should be 80. This port should be 80. And this port should be anything, your wish. So maybe let's take 80 itself. So here, how can I access my application? 80, right? So first of all, so this is my laptop. Maybe let's assume that. This is my laptop. Okay, here in my I will open my browser. I'll type this with colon 80. Okay, my application. So first of all, it will come here. It will connect. Okay, it will enter into this server by using this port. Okay, so obviously to connect this server, maybe to to enter into this port, there should be some network, right? How the network, where, so what is responsible here for your network? ETS0. In ETS0 only, your network is configured, right? So because of that ETS0 only, you are able to connect to this port. Maybe I can take in different way here. I can say like this. This is your ETS0. This is your ETS0. Is it possible without network? It doesn't matter whether you have application, whether you have container here, it doesn't matter. Without network, is it possible to connect to this EC2 instance? No, right? First of all, you should know the address. Is it possible without knowing your address, can I reach you? No, right? First of all, to reach you, I need the address. So this is your IP address. This IP address will be working because of this Ethernet zero only. So you are connecting to this network via ETH zero. Then you are entering into the server by using this EIT port. Here again, how can I reach? So with this EIT port, what is mapped? Again, this EIT port. But how can I reach it? Again, what will happen? There is the communication will be again jump to this network. The communication so from here to again this network. This is again ETH zero, I can say. So again, to reach out to this container, this is my EC2 instance. So let me remove this. So here, instead of directly connecting to this, because the communication cannot be possible directly, so it will go from so it knows the address already, your application, so your connection, so how the packet should be transmitted, maybe transferred, where to transfer, it knows it. So it knows the route also. So there will be whenever a container got created, okay, the container configuration will be stored in Docker host. How to reach out to this container? So this is the route, just this network path. This is called as path. How to reach out to your network? First, it will reach out to ETH zero. So with that, it will enter into the server by using EIT port. And this is just a communication. This is a route. From here, it will reach out to this ETH zero, and with the help of EIT port, it will enter into your server. So that is how it works. Now, is it clear?
Yeah. Thanks.
Okay. So this is what this is how the network communication will happen. Yeah. Okay. So this is what network part, guys. How to reach out to like a Docker host, how the communication will happen over the network. Now let's jump on to Dharmanshu's screen. So one more task I want to give. It is also, guys, don't think that I'm giving like all the things are in a task, okay? Because you should know that these are the scenarios, okay? Real-time scenarios. That's what so I have lots of things like this. But I need a response from you. You have to complete this and come back to me. Okay, then I'll give more tasks. So one more task is, I do have two containers. Okay, I do have two containers, maybe one application container and one database container within the same Docker host. Now I want to link both of them. I want to communicate from one container to one more container. How can I do it? Link both the containers. How can I communicate from one container to another container? That is what your task. What should I do for that? I have an application container and I do have one more database container. Again, it is also very simple. In command line, you have to do some option for that. Okay, let's see how many can do that. So if you cannot, please let me know tomorrow. At first, you have to try it, then come back to me. Don't come without try. Okay, so okay, I think it's enough, guys, for today. So tomorrow is the last class for Docker. We'll explain about one more type of custom image. Okay, so it's enough for today. We'll make it tomorrow then, same time.
Amar, I was just wondering, are you going to let us know how to create a custom image using Dockerfile?
That's what I'm telling. One more way to create custom image.
Okay, got it.
Yeah, just I did not named it, but okay. I told the same thing.
Okay.
So that's a Dockerfile. Yep. One more way to create a custom image.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
So tomorrow we'll see that.
Okay, bye.
Okay then, guys. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Amar.